I have used a wide variety of Linux distributions on my desktops and laptops over the years. One of my favorites has always been Ubuntu. I'm actually a pretty big fan of Ubuntu, even though these days I typically run Arch Linux or one of the Arch Linux-based distributions, mainly for package availability, because Arch, of course, has the AUR, the Arch User Repository, and that thing is a community repository where anybody can package something up, put it in the AUR, and because of how easy it is to do just that, the AUR has virtually every package known to man in it. It really is one of the defining features of Arch Linux. It is one of the biggest reasons why so many people actually run Arch Linux. Now, what if Ubuntu had the AUR? Well, someone has come up with a solution for this problem. They have created a AUR, essentially, for Ubuntu. It's called Pakstall. So Pakstall is hosted over on GitHub. You can go check out the source code. It is free and open source software. It is licensed under the GPL version 3 license. And to install Pakstall on Ubuntu or an Ubuntu-based system, you can grab a Debian file here, a .deb file. There's a link right here. Or if you want to, you can simply install it using curl. Now, out of the box, Ubuntu proper, I don't think, has curl installed by default, so you have to install curl first before running the curl command here to install Pakstall. And once you have Pakstall installed, the commands for it are very similar to, you know, any other package manager like apt or dnf or even pacman. You have sudo pakstall dash capital I for install, and then name of program, sudo pakstall dash capital R for remove, name of program, sudo pakstall dash capital S for doing a search for, name of program, etc. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to go ahead and install this. I've got a virtual machine of Ubuntu 21.04, and we're going to go ahead and install Pakstall. And then to find a list of packages available for Pakstall, other than the Pakstall repository that this guy is maintaining, he is also maintaining this repository of Pakstall dash programs. And what these are, if I go into packages, these are essentially package builds. If you've ever done an AUR package installation on Arch Linux, you've probably seen a package build. For example, if I click on NeoFetch, you have neofetch.packscript. And if I look at it, it looks almost exactly like a Arch Linux package build. Now, some people are going to ask, well, why couldn't you just use Arch Linux package builds, you know, with Ubuntu? Well, Ubuntu and Arch maintain different package names, right? So not the names of certain programs are different compared to the two different distributions. So you can't just use the Arch AUR and Arch package builds in Ubuntu. So you do have to actually build something new. So let me switch over to my VM here of Ubuntu 21.04 Hirsute Hippo. Of course, this is the absolute latest version of Ubuntu. And I'm going to open up a terminal and let me zoom in so you can see the commands. Now, I could grab the deb pack and install Pakstall through the Debian package, or I could use the curl command. I'm going to go ahead and just use the curl command. I've already got curl installed inside this VM. Of course, we need root privileges to install or remove software. And yeah, that was a very quick installation. And now that we've got Pakstall installed, what I need to do is actually install something. Let's do a sudo pakstall dash, I'm going to do dash capital S. Let's search for a package. Now, there was only like 6 or 7 packages currently packaged for Pakstall. I remember NeoFetch was one. And let's just do a search. It says NeoFetch is available. Do you want to view the pack script so we can actually view the package build? And it says failed writing body, so it looks like that is broke. Now, this is brand new stuff here, this Pakstall thing. It's essentially beta software, so if there are some errors, I can't really fault it. It's still early days for it. Let's actually just try to install NeoFetch. We know it's there in the repository, so I'm going to do a sudo pakstall dash capital I NeoFetch. Do we want to view the pack script at first? Sure. And that actually works. So doing the search and then viewing the pack script didn't work, but viewing the pack script when you're trying to install does work. Although the installation itself does not work. It says sudo sto command not found. So this is a dependency issue. Pakstall probably should install this as a dependency when you install it, but I guess for some reason it did not install this particular program here, which is Stow. That's GNU Stow. What that is, it's a symlinking program. I'm assuming that's how it's handling some of these packages. It's symlinking, for example, NeoFetch, when it installs it, you know, to someplace on the file system. So what I'm going to do is, since that's a dependency, let's do a sudo apt install stow and see if that corrects the problem. And we'll wait for stow to install. And now that stow is installed, let's once again sudo pakstall dash capital I NeoFetch. And see, this time, if the installation works, I'll decline viewing the package build this time. And it says installing symlinking files. It looks like everything worked. Let's actually see if NeoFetch launches when I run it. Yep. So we just installed NeoFetch through pakstall, which is essentially an AUR clone for Ubuntu and Ubuntu-based systems. Now, to remove software, you would just run the same command, sudo pakstall dash, instead of I for install, capital R for remove, NeoFetch would uninstall it. And just to verify that NeoFetch is uninstalled, let me try to run it. And yeah, NeoFetch, no such file or directory. Now, currently, because it's brand new, not a lot of people know about pakstall yet, which is one of the reasons I'm making this video, because I think Ubuntu desperately needs this. I really think Ubuntu these days is losing ground to distributions like Arch Linux and the various Arch-based distributions like Manjaro, Endeavor, Arco. It's because they have all the packages, right? They have the AUR, where Ubuntu really doesn't have anything remotely close to the AUR. Pakstall kind of changes the game a little bit, and it's very easy to create these simple pak scripts, these package builds. The creator of pakstall, he's already packaged up 8 things for demo purposes. He's packaged up the adapted GTK theme, GNOME tweaks, KVantum, Nemo, the file manager, NeoFetch, which we just saw, ST-LukeSmith, that's Luke Smith's build of the ST terminal, Stellarium, which I've never played with, but I think it's an astronomy program. And of course, he packaged Vim, which Ubuntu actually doesn't install Vim out of the box either. So it would actually be kind of cool to see if Vim installs correctly. So I'm going to do a sudo pakstall dash capital I Vim. Vim is a more substantial program than NeoFetch. We can review it, you know, make sure that it's not going to do anything malicious. If everything in the package build looks okay, which it does, cue to quit out of reviewing the pack script. And now, of course, it's installing Vim. Vim may take a few minutes to install. It's again, it's a more substantial program, where NeoFetch is basically just a bash script. Actually did not install correctly because stow error. The stow directory user source pakstall does not contain the package Vim. So Vim actually did not install correctly. That's what I was afraid of, because I knew Vim was going to be a little bit more involved as far as building it. Looking at the errors here, it's probably, again, a dependency issue. It says you need to install a terminal library, for example, ncurses. On Linux, that would typically be lib ncurses-deb. Well, we could actually try that and see if it fixes the problem. So let's install those with apt. So I'm going to do a sudo apt install, and then let's see if that's actually the name of the package here in Ubuntu. It may or may not be. So lib ncurses-dev is the name of the package. And now that we've got that installed, let me actually try to install Vim one more time. I'll decline reviewing the package build this time. And we're getting a lot more output in the terminal. I actually think it's going to build correctly this time. I think that was the only thing we needed, was the lib ncurses dash dev libraries there. And that took about 2 minutes to build that. And let's see if Vim actually launches. I'm going to open up the bash rc here in Vim. And of course, Vim runs just fine. So pakstall, I love it. it's great. It's just one of the things I've been saying for years. Man, I wish Ubuntu had an AUR. This really solves a major issue if people jump on board, if people actually start packaging things and actually adding them to the repository here. Now, of course, I did get several errors here playing around with pakstall. We had the dependency issue where GNU Stow was not installed, you know, when you installed pakstall. So that's a dependency. Make sure Stow is installed. I also had to include certain dependencies for some of the packages themselves. His Vim package build probably should list that libincursus-dev package as a dependency. Maybe I will actually go and try to push a correction to his GitHub to try to fix the problem instead of me just saying it. I should actually correct the package build. And because it's a community repository, I know people are going to complain that, oh, you're going to have all these people put broken junk in Packstall, and, you know, you're going to have, like, Vim. The Vim package build obviously was broken. I had to kind of fix it on the fly. Also, you could have people put malicious stuff in it. You know, people can make the same arguments about the AUR. You know, man, there could be malicious code in some of these programs on the AUR. I get that. But you know what? I don't want to hear it. At some point, sometimes you have to go grab third-party packages that are not in your Linux distribution's core repositories. That's just the fact. And, you know, you just got to make your own decisions and hopefully review the package build. And if you know the person that's actually maintaining that package, hopefully it's somebody that you actually trust. So I know I'm going to get flooded in the comments about people saying the AUR is insecure and Packstall is insecure. You know what? I ain't trying to hear all that. Now, before I go, I want to thank a few special people. I want to thank the producers of this episode: Absey, Dallas, Gabe, Lou, Mitchell, Alan, Akami, Arch5430, Choke, David, The Other, David, Dylan, Gregory, Lewis, Paul, Polytech, Scott, Steven, Sven, Wes, and Willie. They're the producers of this episode. Without these guys, you wouldn't know about Packstall. You wouldn't know about it. The show is also brought to you by each and every one of these ladies and gentlemen. All these names you're seeing on the screen right now, these are all my supporters over on Patreon because I'm sponsored by you guys, the community. I don't have any corporate sponsors, and I really appreciate your support. Look for DistroTube over on Patreon. All right, guys. Peace. Now Ubuntu just needs a proper wiki.